Hello children, today I have come up before you with video number 8. Today's topic is simplification and this video is for the standard 5 students. Children, to carry out all the 4 operations together, we follow the rule of BMAS, B-M-A-S. Here we have 4 letters. Later D stands for division, M stands for multiplication, A stands for addition, and S stands for subtraction. We will have to perform these 4 operations in this order. Let us understand it with the help of an example. I am taking a question here. It is 28 divided by 7 plus 16 minus 4 into 2. Children, look here. You will notice this question has all the 4 operations: division, addition, subtraction and multiplication. Out of these 4 operations, first of all, we will do division. Division is here. We have to divide 28 by 7. If we divide 28 by 7, we will get 4. In place of this, 4 is written here and the remaining numbers will be copied. Plus 16 minus 4 into 2. Now, here we have 3 operations: plus, subtraction and multiplication. Out of these 3, we will do multiplication. Multiplication is here, 4 into 2. 4 into 2 will give 8. 4 plus 16 minus 8. Children, at this stage, we have 2 operations, addition and subtraction. Out of these 2 operations, addition will be done. Addition is here, 4 plus 16, it will give you 20, minus 8, and now we have only one operation to perform, that is subtraction. 8 we have to subtract from 20, and the difference will come 12, so 12 is the answer. Children, when brackets, there are 3 brackets that you have to study. This is one bracket, this is second bracket, and this is third bracket. 3 brackets are there. When brackets are present in a simplification, we follow the rule of BODMAS. You have studied BODMAS in previous class also. Operations are performed in the given order. First of all, we do the operation inside the first bracket. Children, this is first bracket. This is first bracket. After this bracket, we have to do operation inside the second bracket or curly bracket. This is also called flower bracket. And third and last bracket is the square bracket. We do operation inside the square bracket after first and curly bracket. Let us understand this with the help of an example. I have taken an example here. Look at this. We have a square bracket, then flower bracket, 35 minus a small bracket, 100 divided by 2, 20. A small bracket closed, flower bracket closed, plus 2 of 5, a square bracket closed. Children, look at this sum. You will notice this sum has all the 3 brackets. We have first bracket here, second bracket, that is curly bracket here, and the square bracket is here. According to the rule of BODMAS, we will perform the operation inside the first bracket, that is this. This is the first bracket. This is the first bracket. We have, inside first bracket, we have division. we have to divide 100 by 20. 100 we have to divide by 20. If we divide 100 by 20, the quotient becomes 5. Student, first of all, in the first step, we will divide 100 by 20. In this operation, we have to perform inside the first brackets, which is written here. 100 divided by 20 gives us 5. See how it will be written here. In place of this, we will write 5. In rest, all we will copy. Square bracket, flower bracket, 35 minus 5, flower bracket closed, plus 2 of 5 is written here. Square bracket closed. Now, look here. Here, now we will perform the operation inside the flower bracket. In what operation we have to do? We have to subtract. 30 minus 5 will give you 30. It is written here. In this state, and this plus sign is copied here, then after plus sign, 2 of 5 is written after plus sign, then square bracket closed. Here we have two operations, plus and off. Between plus and off, off will be done before. So 2 of 5 will give you 10, so 30 plus 10. And the last operation is of addition. 30 plus 10 will give you 40. So 40 is the answer. Students, now we will discuss an important topic, that is estimation. Estimation is also called rounding off. Students, estimation or rounding off, you have studied in class 4 also. In estimation, digit 0, 1, 2, 3 or 4 is rounded off as 0. This is called rounding down. Digit 5, 6, 7, 8 or 9 is rounded off as 10, and this is called rounding up. Let us discuss a few examples to understand estimation. First example is, estimate the sum of 173 plus 125 to the nearest 10. The actual number is 173. If it is rounded off to the nearest 10, let us see what is the digit in nearest in 10's place. 1's 10's, in 10's place we have 7. To round off 7, we will observe the digit in 1's place, it is 3. According to the rule, 3 will be rounded off as 0. So if 173 is rounded off, 17 in the digit that we have in 1's place will become 0. So the rounded off number or the estimated number is 170. The other number is 125. This will be also rounded off to the nearest 10. Again in 10 space we have 2. To round off 2, we have to observe the digit in 1's place. It is 5, and 5 is rounded off as 10. That means we will add 1 to this 2. So 2 plus 1 will give 3. 2 will become, this 2 becomes 3. 1 will remain 1. In what we have in 1's place will become 0. We have in 1's place 5 here, it will become 0. So when 125 is rounded off to the nearest 10, the estimated number or rounded off number is 130. If these two numbers are added, 0 plus 0, 0, 7 plus 3, 10, 0 is written here, 1 we will carry over, above 1, in 100's place, we have 1, 1, 1, 1 plus 1, 2, and again 2 plus 1, 3, so the answer comes 300. This is the answer. In the second example, estimate the difference of 2804 minus 925 to the nearest 100. Children, this number, the bigger number, which is called minimum, 2804, we have to estimate it to the nearest 100. To round off the digit in hundreds place, what is the digit? Let us see. It is 8. And we will observe the digit in tens place. It is 0. So 8 will remain 8. Before 8 we have 2. That will also remain 2. And these two digits 0 and 4 will become 0. That means when 2804 is rounded off to the nearest 100, the estimated number will be 2800. The smaller number, that is 925, also called subtenant. Let us round it off to the nearest 100. What is the digit in hundreds place in 925? It is 9. And what is the digit just after 9 to the right side in tens place? 2. So 2 will be rounded off as 0. So if 925 is rounded off to the nearest 100, the estimated number will be 900. And now we will find the difference between these two numbers. That means we will take away 900 from 2800. 0 minus 0, 0. 0 minus 0, 0. 8 minus 9, we cannot subtract. We will borrow 1 from 2, it will become 18. And it will be 1. 18 minus 9, 9. And 1 minus nothing, that means 1. So the answer comes 1900. Third example, estimate the product of 714 and 549 to the nearest 100. Children, the actual number is 714. If it is rounded off to the nearest 100, what is the digit in hundreds place? 7. And observe the digit just to the right side of 7 in tens place, that is 1. So if it is rounded off, it will become 700. And the other number, that is 549, if it is rounded off to the nearest 100, it will become 500. And the product will be 7 into 5, 35. We have 2 0 here and 2 0 here. So together we have 4 0. We will put 4 0 after 35 to the right side. 1, 2, 3, 4. So we are getting 3,15,000. This is the product of 700 and 500. In the fourth example, estimate the quotient of 278 divided by 27 by estimating the dividend to the nearest 100 and the divisor to the nearest 10. Children, in this division, 278 is the dividend and 27 is the divisor. We have to round off dividend to the nearest 100. 278, if it is rounded off to the nearest 100, in hundreds place we have 2, and we will observe the digit to the right side of 2, in tens place it is 7. 7 will be rounded off as 10. So if 278 is rounded off, it will become 300. 27 we have to round off to the nearest 10. If 27 is rounded off to the nearest 10, it will become 30. So the estimated number, we have 300 here and 30 here. If we divide 300 by 30, the quotient comes 10. Children, I expect you to pick out few sums from exercises given in your textbook and practice them in your notebook. Thank you, children.